Hello everyone, my name is Ikram Çetinkaya and I will be presenting my doctoral symposium paper today.
This will be the agenda of my presentation. When we look at the video streaming, we see that it's quite popular. In fact, 82% of the whole internet traffic is consisting of video content. That means that we have 1 million minutes of video streamed every single second. And when we look at the content characteristics, we can see a shift towards a high resolution content in the recent years. Delivering all these video to the clients is a challenging task, and HTTP adaptive streaming is the de facto solution for that. In HAS, videos are stored in multiple representations with different qualities and resolutions, and the clients can request the one that is the best suited for their network conditions. Preparing the videos is also challenging because of the huge size of the raw videos. Here we call this process as the video encoding, and it consists of multiple building blocks. Block partitioning, motion compensation, transformation and quantization, and the entropy coding are the main building blocks of the encoder sides. On the decoder side, we do the operations in reverse, and at the end, we get the decoded video ready to be displayed. When we look at the video codecs, we can see that every single iteration increases their bitrate saving, but also causing an increase in their time complexity due to the introduction of new coding tools. All this increasing resolution and the video coding complexity requires a need for better enhancements for video encoding. And in this doctoral study, we will try to find solutions for that with the help of machine learning. When we look at the video encoding pipeline, we can see a multiple places where we can apply machine learning and improve the performance. All these things bring us to the research questions, and we come up with four of them. The first one, how can we efficiently provide a multi-rate encoding for the HAS? Because we see that the content resolutions are increasing, meaning that we need more representation for HAS. And in the literature, choosing a representation is the go-to solution. The second question is, how can we improve the performance of videos using machine learning? This is important because we can see that video codecs are getting more and more complex, and there is room for improvement. Third question is, how can we improve the quality of videos using machine learning? We can see in the literature there is a huge increase in image-based enhancement options, but videos are mostly ignored. If we can achieve this, we can achieve a better quality of experience for users. And finally, how can we use machine learning to better assess the perceptual quality assessment? Because the objective metrics we use are not well correlated with the human perception system, this is an important task as well. And the WIMAP recently proposed was using machine learning, and it quickly became an industry standard, and there's still room for improvement for that. And in this doctoral study, we will use the design and abstraction methodology, meaning that we will design a solution, implement it, and then analyze it. We will keep repeating this cycle to improve our solutions. The first existing work from us was the fast multi-rate encoding paper for DCC20 conference. Here, we encode the highest quality representations and use the information to encode the lowest quality one, and then use the information from both of them to encode independent representations. This resulted with the following time graph. We analyzed the results and we saw that parallel encoding performance was not good enough because we couldn't improve the highest time complexity. For that, we came up with a second solution for our second paper that was published in Multimedia Modeling Conference in 2021. Here, we tried to find the optimal starting point for picking a reference representation, and we found that picking the middle quality representation and applying a lower or upper bound is the best solution. And this was the resulting time graph for that. After that, we saw that there is still room for improvement and we can utilize machine learning. And that was our third paper for VC20 conference. Here, we extracted information from the lowest quality representation and used that information to train convolutional neural networks that we used to help speed up the encoding of the higher complexity representations. And this was the time graph we got from the VSIP. We can see a much better improvement in parallel encoding time compared to the MMM paper. And finally, we wanted to extend this to our multi-resolution scenarios, which was our paper for IEEE OGSP journal. Here, we used the highest quality representation from the lowest resolution as the reference representation and used the information to encode all remaining representations. We trained different CNNs for each QPN resolution level. And this was the time graph we had. Finally, I will be talking about my ongoing and future works. This is the timeline of our doctoral study. We first started with the multi-rate and resolution encoding, which resulted with our first and second papers. After that, we worked on how can we improve the machine learning, video codecs with machine learning, and that resulted with the VC20 paper. Also, the extension to the multi-resolution scenarios, IEEE OGSP journal paper. As of now, we are working on the super resolution to improve the visual quality of videos. More specifically, a mobile platform to apply super resolution. After that, we will start with addressing research question 4 and research question 1 again. Also, we will plan to use the machine learning to improve the visual quality of videos or video codecs. And finally, we will conclude the study with the thesis plan. This was all from my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. I will be happy to answer your questions. Thank you.